Hello everyone, welcome to the class of Complex Analysis, Probability and Statistical Methods, 18 Math 4-1. Today I'll be teaching a topic in Module 4, Statistical Methods, and the topic name is Correlation and Regression. Myself, Dr. Madhura, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. Now first we will know the definition for correlation. Correlation, covariation of two independent magnitudes is known as correlation. Covariation of two independent magnitudes is known as correlation. So it is the covariation of two independent magnitudes, which is known as the correlation for us. Now the numerical measure of correlation between two variables x and y is known as Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, and we usually denote this by the alphabet R, small letter R, and the definition can be written. So we will just pin the same. The numerical measure of correlation between two variables x and y is known as Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, denoted by letter R. It is defined as R is equal to sigma capital X into Y divided by square root of sigma X square into square root of sigma y square, where capital X is equal to x minus x bar and capital Y is equal to y minus y bar, where x bar is the mean of x, that is sum of all x values divided by n. Similarly, y bar is sum of all y values divided by n. So there's alternate formula also for coefficient of correlation. So we'll just also make a note of that. So alternately, R is equal to sigma x square plus sigma y square minus sigma x minus y square, the whole divided by 2 into sigma x into sigma y, where sigma x square is equal to summation capital X square divided by N, and sigma Y square is equal to summation capital Y square divided by N. So this is about Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. So Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation is denoted by R, and this is the formula what we apply while doing problems, where capital X stands for X minus X bar, where X bar is the mean of X values, and capital Y stands for Y minus Y bar, where Y bar is the mean of all Y values. Now we will note some of the important points required while doing problems. Note, the coefficient of correlation does not exceed unity. The meaning of this is coefficient of correlation is denoted by R. R does not increase unity. It does not exceed unity means R values lies between minus 1 to plus 1. R value lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Second point, if R is plus or minus 1, R is equal to plus or minus 1, then x and y are perfectly correlated. And if R is equal to 0, then x and y are non-correlated. So these are some of the points that we want to know about coefficient of correlation. So coefficient of correlation R lies between minus 1 to 1. So when we solve some problems, suppose R is crossing beyond this range, then somewhere some calculations might be wrong. So we can just clarify ourselves that R ranges between minus 1 to plus 1. And R takes plus 1 or minus 1, then X and Y are said to be perfectly correlated. And if R is equal to 0, then X and Y are non-correlated. Then, now we will understand the definition for regression. Regression is an estimation of one independent variable in terms of the other. Regression is an estimation of one independent variable. In terms of the other. So regression lines are actually two in number. We usually represent y in terms of x or x in terms of y. So there are two regression lines. The regression line of y on x is defined, and similarly the regression line of x on y is also defined. We'll see that now. The regression line of y on x is given by capital Y is equal to summation x into y divided by summation x square multiplied by x, or alternately y minus y bar is equal to R into sigma y divided by sigma x multiplied by x minus x bar. This is regression line of y on x. And similarly, the regression line of x on y is given by capital X is equal to sigma x into y divided by sigma y square multiplied by capital Y. Or this is one and the same as writing alternate formula. X minus x bar is equal to R into sigma x divided by sigma y multiplied by y minus y bar. So these are the regression lines of y on x and x on y. The definition itself says that we are representing, it's an estimation of one independent variable in terms of the other. So we are writing regression line of y on x, similarly x on y. Now we will note some of the points which are important while doing problems. Note. The coefficient of x in equation 1 and coefficient of y in equation 2 respectively given by r into delta y sigma y divided by sigma x and r into sigma x divided by sigma y. Here we can observe in equation 1 the coefficient of x is r into sigma y by sigma x, and here in equation 2 you can observe the coefficient of y is r into sigma x by sigma y. That is what we have written just now, are known as regression coefficients, and their product is equal to r square. So the regression coefficients are denoted by the coefficient of x in equation 1 and the coefficient of y in equation 1. That is r into sigma y by sigma x, r into sigma x by sigma y. These are the coefficients. They are known as regression coefficients. And when we take the product of these two regression coefficients, we observe that sigma y by sigma x multiplied by sigma x by sigma y gets cancelled. R into r becomes r square. So the product of these two is equal to r square. The same we will write it down symbolically now. That is, r square is equal to coefficient of x multiplied by coefficient of y. This is from the regression lines. So this implies r is equal to plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. Plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. And the sign of r here, either it will take plus sign or the minus sign. The sign of r will be positive or negative according as the regression coefficients are positive or negative. The sign of r will be positive or negative according as the regression coefficients are respectively positive or negative. Means if the regression coefficients both are positive, then r will be positive. If the regression coefficients both are negative, then r will be negative. So these are some of the points which we had to note while doing problems in the correlation and regression. Now we will see problems on correlation and regression. First one, find the coefficient of correlation and the equation of the lines of regression and the equation of lines of regression for the following data. Let us write down the given set of values of x and y. 1 to 5 are the values of x given. Respective values of y are 2, 5, 3, 8, 7. Now, So very firstly, we have to find out the coefficient of correlation followed by the lines of regression. So to find out the coefficient of correlation, we'll write on the formula. Coefficient of correlation is given by R is equal to sigma x into y divided by square root of sigma x square multiplied by square root of sigma y square. So this is our formula to find out coefficient of correlation. Now it depends whether we want to use this formula or the alternate formula in terms of sigma x and sigma y. So I'll be applying the coefficient of correlation formula in this form in terms of the big letters, where capital X is equal to x minus x bar and capital Y is equal to y minus y bar. Now let us find out the x bar and y bar, the mean values. So x bar is sum of all x values divided by n, and y bar is sum of all y values divided by n, where n is the number of sets of data given for us. So there are 5 sets of data given in the question, so n is equal to 5. Now let us substitute sum of all x values, adding up 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Sum of all x values gives us 15 divided by 5. So this is 15 divided by 5, which gives us 3. Similarly, y bar is sum of all y values divided by n. So the n is 5 again. Sum of all y means 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 8 plus 7, which gives us 25 divided by 5, which is 5. So once we know x bar and y bar, we can form the relevant table. Now table will be prepared according to what summations are required for us. We are in need of summation capital X into capital Y, summation X square and summation Y square. So accordingly, we have to prepare the table. Obviously, the first two columns are X and Y, small x, small y. But we will be writing down the data in terms of capital X and capital Y. So capital X is nothing but X minus X bar, so which will be X minus 3. And capital Y will be Y minus Y bar, which will be Y minus 5. Y bar value is 5, no? That is Y. So let's prepare the relevant table first, followed by the table values. The first two columns are for X and Y. First column is for X. Second column is for Y values, followed by capital X, capital Y, and then we have to find out capital X into Y, capital X square, capital Y square. So we want 3 more columns, capital X into Y, capital X square, capital Y square values. Now let us fill the particular columns and start finding one by one. So first column is for X, Y. Capital X is X minus X bar, which is 3. Capital Y is Y minus Y bar, which is 5. Then we have X into Y, X square, Y square to find out, which is required for equation 1. Summations are required for equation 1. So let us fill given set of X and Y values first. So these are the given values of X and Y, no? Let us fill them in the first two columns. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then Y values are 2, 5, 3, 8, 7. Now let us find capital X first, which is X minus X bar, which is 3. So X minus 3 means 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Similarly, X minus 3. So 2 minus 3. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. 3 minus 3 is 0. 4 minus 3 is 1. 5 minus 3 is 2. Similarly, capital Y is Y minus 5. The Y column, minus 5. So 2 minus 5, minus 3. 5 minus 5, 0. 3 minus 5, minus 2. 8 minus 5 is 3. 7 minus 5 is 2. So these are the values of capital Y. Now we need to do the product, capital X into capital Y. So do not get confused. We are not doing the product of small x and small y. We are doing the product of capital X and Y. So we have to go ahead by doing the product of these two columns. So which gives us 6, 0, 0, 3, 4. Now capital X square. Capital X, we have these values as capital X. We will square them and write it down here. So which gives us 4, 1, 0, 1, 4. Capital Y square. 3 square is 9, 0, 4, minus 2 the whole square is 4, 9, 4. 9, 0, 4, 9, 4. 4, 1, 0, 1, 4 are the values of capital X square. So with all these values, we need to sum up. Which all summations are required by looking into equation 1, we can decide. We are in requirement of summation capital XY, summation capital X square, and summation capital Y square only. So let us sum it up. Summation capital X into Y, summation capital X square, summation capital Y square. And the respective values are 13, using calculator you can do this, 10 and 26. Now we will substitute all these values into equation 1 to find out the coefficient of correlation. This is nothing but the Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, or simply coefficient of correlation. So substituting in equation 1, R is equal to numerator is 13 divided by square root of 10 into square root of 26. So we can round off this answer to 2 decimal places. So R is approximately 0.81. Did we observe that R value should range between minus 1 to plus 1? In the theory we learned this, that coefficient of correlation does not exceed unity. So R value should lie between minus 1 to plus 1. And that is happening for us. So this is how we do coefficient of correlation, which is the first part of the problem. Now we have to move ahead to find out the second part of the problem. That is nothing but the lines of regression. Let us find lines of regression now. Lines of regression are given by, there are two lines of regression. One is regression line of y on x and the other one is regression line of x on y. So I'll just respectively write on the formula, capital Y is equal to sigma x into y divided by sigma x square multiplied by capital X, and capital X is equal to sigma x into y divided by sigma y square multiplied by capital Y. Now let us substitute all the values. Capital Y stands for y minus y bar and capital X stands for x minus x bar. Left hand side is y minus y bar is equal to sigma xy. Just now we obtained from the table sigma xy is 13 divided by sigma x square, which is 10. So 13 divided by 10 multiplied by capital X is x minus x bar. We'll solve one of them first. Later we will move to the second one. So y minus 5 is equal to, y bar is 5, is equal to 1.3 into x minus. Let us simplify this. Y minus 5 is equal to 1.3x minus 3.9, which on simplification gives us y is equal to 1.3x. We are substituting minus 5 to the right hand side, which becomes plus 5. So 5 minus 3.9 is 1.1. So this is the regression line of y on x, which looks similar to the straight line equation y is equal to ax plus b form. Correct? It's a straight line equation, that is why line. So line of regression, but there are two regression lines. This is regression line of y on x. Now similarly we'll find out regression line of x on y. Regression line of x on y we will find out. So continuing on the same lines for the second one, x minus x bar is equal to sigma x into y is 13 divided by 26 into y minus y bar. So this is x minus 3 is equal to 0.5 multiplied by y minus 5. So x minus 3 is equal to 0.5y minus 2.5. And that gives us x is equal to 0.5y. We will take this minus 3 to the other side. So it becomes plus 3. So 3 minus 2.5. 3 minus 2.5 is 0.5. So this is a regression line of x on y. So we were asked to find out Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation, that is R. R value is 0.81, followed by the lines of regression for the given data. So usually they ask both the lines of regression. So lines of regression means you are going to find out y on x as well as x on y. Now we will take up second question. Second problem. Find the coefficient of correlation. Find the coefficient of correlation and the lines of regression for the following data. So the values of x and y are given for us. X values are from 1 to 10. In steps of 1, respective values of y are 10, 12, 16, 28, 25, 36, 41, 49, 40, 50. So first we have to find out the coefficient of correlation R followed by the lines of regression. So let us follow the same procedure to find. We'll find out or first write on the formula for coefficient of correlation, which is given by R is equal to summation x into y divided by square root of summation x square multiplied by square root of summation y square, where x is equal to x minus x bar and capital Y is equal to y minus y bar. So capital X, capital Y we have to find out means we want to know the mean of x and the mean of y. That is x bar and y bar we should know first. So therefore x bar is equal to sum of all x values divided by n. Here sum of all x values, when we sum it up using a calculator, we can obtain 55 divided by 10, which is equal to 5.5. Similarly, y bar is summation y divided by n. Summation y, you can sum up all the values of y using a calculator, which gives us 307 divided by 10. There are 10 sets of data given for us. From the given data, there are 10 sets. So 307 divided by 10 gives us 30.7. So what happens to capital X then? Capital X will be X minus X bar is 5.5. Capital Y will be Y minus Y bar is 30.7. So sometimes it can be decimal values over here. 5.5, 30.7 as you are seeing. So if it is decimals also, not to worry. Just use the calculator and simplify all the values. So while in the tabular column also, in the such cases, we will be getting maximum decimal values only. So let us tabulate the values now. The first two columns are for x and y, same like last problem. Then we have capital X is equal to x minus x bar. Capital Y is equal to y minus y bar. So we need columns for capital X followed by capital Y. Then we have X into Y, X into Y, X square column, and lastly column for Y square. So let us first write down the given data, X and Y. First two columns are for X and Y. X values are from 1 to 10. Y values respectively are 10, 12, 16, 28, 25, 36, 41, 49, 40, 50. These are the respective values of Y. The next column is for capital X. Capital X is X minus X bar. X bar is 5.5. Capital Y is Y minus 30.7. Y minus Y bar. So Y bar is 30.7. Then it will be X into Y, X square and Y square. So I've used calculator and I'll be writing the values directly. Even you can do the same. Capital X is X minus 5.5. X values are 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So 1 minus 5.5, 2 minus 5.5, 3 minus 5.5. Like that, we have to calculate all the values of this column. So let us do that, which gives us minus 4.5, minus 3.5, minus 2.5, minus 1.5, minus 0.5, plus 0.5, 1.5, 2.5, 3.5, 4.5. This was capital X values. Similarly, capital Y is Y minus 30.7. So 10 minus 30.7, 12 minus 30.7, 16 minus 30.7. Like that, we need to evaluate for each values in this column. That is minus 20.7, minus 18.7, minus 14.7, minus 2.7, minus 5.7, 5.3, 10.3, 18.3, 9.3, and 19.3. So obviously these are time consuming. Whenever it comes to decimal especially, it takes time to evaluate each of these values. Now we need to do X into Y, capital X into capital Y. Forget about the first two columns. Their work is over already. When you evaluated X minus 5.5 and Y minus 30.5, its task is done. So now you just have to concentrate on capital X and capital Y values. It's a product of these two, X into Y column. So that gives us 93.15, 65.45, 36.75, 4.05, 2.85, 2.65, 15.45, 45.75, 32.55, and lastly 86.85. So these are capital X into Y product of these two columns using the calculator. Now similarly, capital X square and capital Y square values. Capital X, these are the capital X values, these are the capital Y values. You have to square them and we have to write it down here. So which gives us respectively 20.25, 12.25, 6.25, 2.25, 0.25, again 0.25, 2.25, 6.25, 12.25, and 20.25. If we observe while squaring these values, If we have minus 4.5 at the top, we had a plus 4.5. Anyway, square value gives us the same thing. Similarly, 3.5, 3.5, minus 3.5, 2.5, minus 2.5. So square values gives the same thing. Now capital Y square we have to perform, that is 20.7, minus 20.7 whole square, minus 18.7 whole square, like that. We need to perform for capital Y square column. So that gives us 428.49, 349.69, 216.09, 7.29, 32.49, 28.09, 106.09, 334.89, 86.49, and lastly 372.49. So these were the values of capital Y square column for us. Now, since we already know capital XY, capital X square, capital Y square values, we will sum it up. Well, by taking the sum, we will be able to substitute all the values into the formula which we have already written. Okay, we will sum it up. Now, the sum of these values, which will be in requirement is only capital XY values, capital X square values, and capital Y square values. So that gives us summation capital X into Y is 385.5, and summation capital X square values is 82.5, and summation capital Y square value is 1962.1. So these summations are required for us while we need to substitute for equation 1, that is to find out the coefficient of correlation. So let us substitute in equation 1 and find it out. Substitute in equation 1 to find out R is equal to, it is summation X into Y, that is 385.5 divided by square root of 82.5 into square root of 1962.1. So this gives us R approximately 0.96. We again observe that the coefficient of correlation lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So 0.96 is a value between minus 1 to plus 1. Now we will evaluate the lines of regression. The lines of regression formula for them. So lines of regression are given by capital Y is equal to sigma X into Y divided by sigma X square multiplied by capital X. Similarly, capital X is equal to sigma X into Y divided by sigma Y square multiplied by capital Y. Now substituting capital Y as Y minus Y bar and capital X as X minus X bar, and substituting the values from the table for capital XY, sigma capital XY and sigma X square, we'll be able to simplify this and obtain the line of regression of Y on X. And from the second one, we will be able to obtain the regression line of X on Y. The same after simplification gives us, this is Y minus Y bar is equal to 385.5 divided by 82.5 multiplied by X minus X bar and the second one, we'll take up the second one. So this on simplification gives us Y minus 30.7 is equal to 4.6727 multiplied by X minus 5.5. So this on simplification, Y is 4.6727 into X plus 5. So this is regression line of Y on X. Now similarly, we can do the other one, that is regression line of X on Y. So we have capital X value here. Capital X is equal to summation X into Y divided by summation X squared into Y. So this gives us X minus X bar is equal to sigma x into y is 385.5 divided by summation y square is 1962.1 multiplied by y minus y bar. Y minus y bar. So this continues to obtain the answer as x minus x bar. X bar is 5.5 is equal to 0.1965 multiplied by y minus 30.7. And this on simplification will give us regression line of x on y. So x is equal to 0.1965 into y minus 0.5326. So these are the regression lines of y on x and regression line of x on y. So this is how we do problems on coefficient of correlation, finding coefficient of correlation first, followed by the lines of regression. The alternate form of the problems, we'll see it in the next session. So we have the lines of regression as first and hence finding the coefficient of correlation. Means finding the lines of regression first using the alternate formula what we discussed in the theory, we'll be able to also find the coefficient of correlation R, which should lie between minus 1 to plus 1. We'll see third problem now. In this problem, we'll be finding the lines of regression first, followed by the coefficient of correlation. So question is, obtain the lines of regression. Obtain the lines of regression and hence find the coefficient of correlation. Coefficient of correlation for the following data. Write on the given set of values of x and y. It is given as x values are from 1 to 7 in steps of 1, and the respective values of y are 9, 8, 10, 12, 11, 13, 14. So these are the respective values of y. Now we have to find the lines of regression first, and using the solution of the lines of regression, we have to obtain the coefficient of correlation. That is why they have used the word hence find. So let us see how to do. First, we will be finding the lines of regression. So we need to write down the formula for lines of regression. Okay, solution. We'll write down the formula first for lines of regression. The lines of regression are, there are two formulae. One is y on x and x on y. So y is equal to sigma x into y divided by sigma x square multiplied by x. And the second one is capital X is equal to sigma x into y divided by sigma y square multiplied by y. So these are the two lines of regression. One is y on x, the other one is x on y. We will write down what are capital X and capital Y. So where capital X is equal to x minus x bar and capital Y is equal to y minus y bar. What are x bar and y bar? They are nothing but the mean of x. Mean of x. Let us find out the mean of x. Then we sum up all the values of x, summation x. We are going to get 28. Sum up all the values of x, which is 28, divided by n. N is the total number of sets of data given for us. So there are 7 set of data given for us. So x bar is 4. Similarly, y bar. Y bar is sum of all y values divided by n. When we sum up all the given set of y values, we'll be getting 77 divided by 7. N is equal to 7, so which gives us 11. So we have x bar is equal to 4 and y bar is equal to 11. Now we will form a relevant table. So for the table, the first two columns are x and y. The given set of values of x and y will be used. Then the next column will be for capital X and capital Y. So capital X and capital Y are X minus X bar and Y minus Y bar. X bar and Y bar we have already found out. So we will be using those values. And followed by we have to find out sigma capital XY, sigma X square and sigma Y square. So columns will be framed for X into Y, X square and Y square. First two columns are for X and Y, followed by capital X, which is X minus X bar, capital Y, which is Y minus Y bar, then we have X into Y, X square and Y square. We'll write down quickly the values of X and Y given to us. So 1 to 7 are the given set of values of x and y values are respectively 9, 8, 10, 12, 11, 13, 14. So we have capital X is equal to x minus x bar, which is 4, and capital Y is equal to y minus y bar, which is 11. Then followed by x into y, x square and y square. X square and y square. So let us find out x minus 4. Small x minus 4. 1 minus 4 is minus 3. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. Like that we are finding all the values for this column capital X. So they are respectively minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and 3. The next column is y minus 11. Respective values are 9 minus 11, 8 minus 11, 10 minus 11, etc. So they are minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, 1, 11 minus 11 is 0. Then we have 2, 3. X into Y. The product of these two columns, X into Y, should be done now for the next one. So that gives us 3 into 2, 6, 6, 1, 0, 0. 9. X square. This is capital X square. Do not get confused. We find out all the values of capital X square now. So that gives us 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, 9. Similarly, Y square gives us 4, 9, 1, 1, 0, 4, 9. So of course, now we have to sum up sigma capital X into Y, sigma X square and sigma Y square. These three summations are required for us. Summing up all the values of X into Y, we obtain 26. Summation X square we obtain as 28. Similarly, summation Y square also we obtain the answer as 28. You can use a calculator to get these answers. Now we will substitute all these summations into equation 1 to find the lines of regression. Substituting in equation 1, left hand side y minus y bar is equal to sigma capital XY divided by sigma x square into x minus x bar. I am substituting in one of them first. Later we will go with the second one. So we have y minus y bar is 11. 26 by 28 gives us 0.9286 into x minus 4. X bar is 4. So this on simplification gives us y is equal to 0.9286 into x minus 0.9286 multiplied by 4 gives us 3.7144 plus 11. I've taken minus 11 to the other side. So this gives us the answer as 9286x plus 7.2856. This is one of the regression line. This is regression line of y on x. We are obtaining y on x. That is why we call it as regression line of y on x. Now similarly, we can find out regression line of x on y, substituting in other equation of equation 1. In this equation, I'm substituting now capital X is equal to sigma xy divided by sigma y square into y. So we obtain x minus x bar is equal to 26 by 28 multiplied by y minus y bar. So this is x minus 4 is equal to 0.9286 into y minus 11. Or x is equal to 0.9286y. Now we have 0.9286 into 11. So when we perform that, we obtain there's a minus sign, so 10.2146, and minus 4 taken to the other side becomes plus 4. So simplifying the constants, we obtain x is equal to 0.9286y minus 6.2146. This is another regression line of x on y. So these are the regression lines, which is nothing but the first part of the problem. First part of the problem was to find the lines of regression. Now the second one, hence find the coefficient of correlation. Now the word hence find means that we need to use the regression lines and then we need to find the coefficient of correlation. So let us write down the alternate formula for coefficient of correlation. So I'm using the alternate formula for coefficient of correlation. Therefore, coefficient of correlation r is equal to plus or minus square root of coefficient of x multiplied by coefficient of y. We observe the lines of regression. From this, the coefficient of x is 0.9286. This is coefficient of x from the regression line of y on x. Similarly, coefficient of y from this is 0.9286. Again, from this, the regression line of x on y, the coefficient of y is 0.9286. So these coefficients will be multiplied under the root. That gives us 0.9286 into 0.9286 under the root. So we get plus 0.9286, which is approximately rounded off to two decimal places as 0.93. Now we have taken plus sign here. We have taken plus sign here because since both the regression coefficients are positive, these coefficient of x and coefficient of y are known as the regression coefficients. Since both the regression coefficients are positive, we are considering r to be positive. If suppose both the regression coefficients are negative, then we will be consider r value as negative. So we will mention the same thing as a reason to understand. R is positive here. The sign of r is positive since both the regression coefficients, r is positive value here. So that is how we find out easily the coefficient of correlation using the alternate formula. It was because we were asked to find out the lines of regression followed by coefficient of correlation using that formula with respect to lines of regression. Means using lines of regression, we were supposed to find out the coefficient of correlation here. Now we do another problem which is different from this. The lines of regression are given for us. We need to find the means of x and y, and hence the correlation coefficient. Given 2x plus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0, x plus 6y minus 4 is equal to 0 are the two regression lines, Find the mean of x, y's and the coefficient of correlation. So we need to find the mean of x and y and hence find the coefficient of correlation as well. So let us see the solution for this. We recall from the theory that the regression lines passes through the mean of x and y. This regression lines passes through x bar comma y bar. So since this is the case, we must have the given equations 2x plus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0 and x plus 6y minus 4 is equal to 0 in terms of x bar and y bar. So we must have the given equations with respect to x bar and y bar. So 2x bar plus 3y bar is equal to minus 1. And the second equation is x bar plus 6y bar is equal to 4. So we need to solve these equations simultaneously to obtain the answer for mean x bar and y bar. The regression lines always passes through the means of x and y. That is the reason we will be able to write down like this. That is, given equations in terms of x bar and y bar, we are able to write down. So solving them simultaneously, we obtain x bar is equal to minus 2 and y bar is equal to 1. X bar is minus 2 and y bar is equal to 1. Now, given two equations, we will rewrite, which is going to help us to write down the or find out the coefficient of correlation from the regression lines. See, these two are the regression lines given for us, but they are not represented in the usual manner. That is like representing y as a function of x or representing x as a function of y. We want to write down regression line of y on x and regression line of x on y in this format. So to write down in that format, first we will represent the given two equations as equations 1 and 2. So I'm just rewriting the given equations first. So given 2x plus 3y is equal to minus 1, I'll call this as equation 1, and x plus 6y is equal to 4. Now, we don't know from the first one, we can represent regression line of y on x or x on y. Similarly, from the second one, we don't know whether we can represent regression line of x on y or y on x. So we will assume one of the format first and we will proceed whether that is going to help us to say it is a regression line of y on x and x on y respectively. So suppose we write, from equation 1, we will try to represent what is y. So 3y will be equal to minus 2x minus 1, or dividing throughout by 3, we will be obtaining minus 0.667x minus 0.33. So this is one of the line for me, say regression line of y on x. Y is equal to minus 0.667x minus 0.3333. Similarly, we will try to represent from equation 2, we will try to represent another equation, that is x is equal to. From the first one, I'm trying to write down what is y. From the second equation, I'm trying to write down what is x. This might be the regression lines. We don't know. We will get confirmation once we find out correlation coefficient r. So let us represent x is equal to from the second one. So x is plus 4 minus 6y plus 4. So from this we will be able to write down the coefficient of x and coefficient of y. So let us see what happens to r. R is equal to square root of plus or minus square root of coefficient of x multiplied by coefficient of y. So this gives us plus or minus square root of coefficient of x from the first one is 0.667. Coefficient of y is minus 6. When we obtain an answer for this, this is minus 2. This becomes a contradiction because r value should lie between minus 1 to plus 1. Let me explain once again. From the given equations 1 and 2, I tried to represent y from the first one and x from the second one. So these were the two equations which I obtained. Now here the coefficient of x is minus 0.667. Here the coefficient of y from the second one is minus 6. Then formula for coefficient correlation r is equal to plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. When I did the product under the root here, we obtained the answer as minus 2. It is minus because both the regression coefficients were negative. So we obtained the answer approximately as minus 2. But this is a contradiction to the r value because we are familiar from the theory. We recall that coefficient of correlation should lie between minus 1 to plus 1 only. So since r should lie between minus 1 to plus 1 only, this becomes a contradiction. So this value of r is not agreeable. And hence, now we need to proceed in the alternate forms of equation 1 and 2. The alternate forms of equation 1 and 2 means from the first one, we should be expressing what is x is equal to. And from the second equation, we should be expressing what is y is equal to. So let us rewrite equations 1 and 2 to obtain the actual lines of regression. So from equation 1, I can write it down. 2x is equal to minus 3y minus 1, or x is equal to minus 1.5y minus 0.5. This is one of the regression line. And similarly, from the second one, I can represent what is 6y is equal to minus x plus 4, and hence y is equal to minus 0.1667x plus 4. Dividing throughout by 6 we are doing, no? So this becomes 0.667. I'm sorry. 4 divided by 6. We are dividing throughout by 6 here. So this becomes 0.667. Now, what is coefficient of x from the second one? The second one, coefficient of x is minus 0.1667. From the first one, the coefficient of y is minus 1.5. So let us substitute in the formula and find out r. R will be plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y minus 1.5. Since both the regression coefficients are negative, our answer also will be a negative one. Of course, under the root, minus into minus will be plus, or we can aramse obtain the square root value of this, and that will be equal to 0.5. And negative answer, r is negative because both the regression coefficients are negative. We will mention the reason. R must be negative since both the regression coefficients, are negative. Both the regression coefficients are negative. So this is how we find out R. So there were two parts of the question. One is to find out the mean x bar and y bar. So regression lines always passes through the mean of x and y also. So that is why we were able to represent the given lines in terms of x bar, y bar. Solving simultaneously, we obtain x bar and y bar values easily, minus 2 and 1. The second part of the problem is to express the given equation in form in the standard form of the regression line, line of y on x and x on y. In order to do that, we represented first, from the first one I took y is equal to, from the second one I considered x is equal to, but that was not satisfying because r was beyond the range minus 1 and plus 1. So that is why we have rewritten the given equations, expressing from the first equation I wrote what is x, and from the second one I was able to express what is y. And that is how we are obtaining r into the range. R is equal to minus 0.5, lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So it is an agreeable value. Now we'll see one last problem, which behaves as a standard derivation for us. If theta is the angle between the lines of regression, if theta is the angle between the lines of regression, then show that tan theta is equal to sigma x into sigma y, the whole divided by sigma x square plus sigma y square multiplied by 1 minus r square divided by r. Also, explain the significance of tan theta when r is equal to 0 and r is equal to plus or minus 1. Explain the significance of tan theta when r is equal to 0 and r is equal to plus or minus 1. So this behaves as a standard derivation for us. This we are doing with respect to the angle theta, which is acting as an angle between the lines of regression. So let us do the proof for this. Proof. If theta is an acute angle, then the angle between the lines y is equal to m1x plus c1 and y is equal to m2x plus c2 is given by tan theta is equal to m2 minus m1 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. We are familiar with this formula that if theta is the angle between the lines y is equal to m1x plus c1 and y is equal to m2x plus c2, the two lines y is equal to mx plus c form we are considering. And for these two lines, if theta behaves as the angle between them, then we are familiar from the basics that tan theta is equal to m2 minus m1, or this can be m1 minus m2 also. We can consider the magnitude of m1 minus m2 we can consider here. So this behaves as m2 minus m1 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. We will denote this by equation 1. Now the lines of regression are given by, we are familiar from the correlation regression concept, the lines of regression are given by y minus y bar is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x into x minus x bar. We'll denote this by equation 2. And the other one is x minus x bar is equal to r into sigma x divided by sigma y multiplied by y minus y bar. We'll represent this by equation 3. These are the lines of regression of y on x and x on y. We are familiar with this. Now we will write down the slopes of 1 and 2. This is of the form y is equal to mx plus c form. So m into x. So I can write down m1 from the first equation. Similarly, m2 from the second equation. But before I write down the second one, that is equation 3, I have to rewrite the equation in the standard form y is equal to mx plus c form. So we will rewrite equation 3. Rewrite equation 3 as y minus y bar is equal to y minus y bar is equal to sigma y divided by r into sigma x multiplied by x minus x bar. We are rewriting equation 2 in terms of y minus y bar. So I cross multiplied r into sigma x by sigma y to the left hand part, which gave me sigma y by r into sigma x multiplied by x minus x bar form. Correct? Now this I'll call it as equation 4, which is going to help me to write down the slopes. Now we will write down slope from equation 2 and 4. We will write down slopes from equations 2 and 4. So slopes of equations 1 and 2, equations 2 and 4 are, so now observe both equation 2 and 4, both are of the form y is equal to mx plus c. Y is equal to, and this is also y is equal to, capital Y we can assume. So capital Y is equal to mx plus c form, here also it is of the same form. So I'll, from the second one, I'll write it down and denote as m1. From this third, fourth equation, I will denote it as, say, m2. So m1 is equal to r into sigma y divided by sigma x, and from the fourth equation m2 is equal to sigma y divided by r into sigma x. Now these are our m1 and m2 values, which we are going to substitute in equation 1. Let us now substitute into equation 1. Both these values we are now trying to substitute into equation 1. We need to simplify that equation. Substituting in equation 1, tan theta is equal to, we have written m2 minus m1. We have written m2 minus m1. So sigma y by r sigma x minus r sigma y by sigma x. Like that we have to substitute. So sigma y divided by r into sigma x minus r into sigma y divided by sigma x, the whole divided by we have 1 plus m1 into m2. So 1 plus m1 into m2, r into sigma y by sigma x multiplied by sigma y by r sigma x. So r get cancelled here, sigma x sigma y also get cancelled. If we observe, sigma y also gets cancelled, sigma x also get, they are getting actually multiplied, I'm sorry. Sigma y, this remains as it is. Okay, now we will simplify this further. So tan theta is equal to numerator. Let us observe what is common in the numerator. So numerator, I have sigma y by sigma x common. So I will write down sigma y by sigma x common, and we remain as 1 by r minus r. Denominator, it is 1 plus sigma y square divided by sigma x square. So we need to take LCM and simplify. So we have sigma y by sigma x multiplied by 1 minus r square divided by r after taking LCM in the numerator. Denominator sigma x square is the LCM, numerator it will be sigma x square plus sigma y square. So this is the LCM. Now we can cancel the term. Sigma x cancels in the denominator, 1 power cancels, and what do we remain? Power 1 remains. Denominator of denominator goes to the numerator. So this will be equal to tan theta is equal to sigma x into sigma y divided by sigma x square plus sigma y square multiplied by 1 minus r square divided by r. And that's our requirement. That's our requirement in the proof. Tan theta is equal to sigma x into sigma y divided by sigma x square plus sigma y square multiplied by 1 minus r square divided by r. Correct? No? That is our requirement. So if need by, we will call this as equation 5. We will be in need of it because we need to now explain the significance of tan theta when r is equal to 0 and r is equal to plus or minus 1. So now we will see the significance of the same. Now when r is equal to 0, that's the first value given for us, no? When r is equal to 0, let's see what happens to tan theta. So when r is 0, this becomes an infinite value. So tan theta is equal to infinity. If tan theta is infinity, theta will be 90 degrees. So the lines of regression are perpendicular to each other and hence the variables are uncorrelated. Uncorrelated. We'll explain the same thing. If r is equal to 0, equation 5 implies tan theta is equal to infinity and theta is equal to pi by 2. Theta will be pi by 2. Therefore, the lines of regression, are perpendicular and hence the variables are uncorrelated and similarly what is the next one that we have to discuss we have to now take r is equal to plus or minus 1 if r is plus 1 or minus 1 equation 5 implies tan theta will be equal to 0 and hence theta will be equal to 0. Whether r is plus 1 or minus 1, whatever we take here, r square becomes 1. So 1 minus 1 will be 0. So and hence tan theta will be 0 or theta itself will be equal to 0. And this implies for us that the two regression lines coincide and hence the variables are perfectly correlated. Therefore, the lines of regression coincide and hence the variables are perfectly correlated. So if r is 0, the lines are perpendicular to each other and hence the variables are uncorrelated and when r is plus or minus 1, we obtain theta equal to 0 means both the lines, there's no angle at all. So lines of regression coincide, they are overlapping on each other and hence the variables are perfectly correlated. So this is how we do problems on correlation and regression. Hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you for watching.